Muthsera? Go ahead, Outlander. What do you need?
Oh, everybody's friendly now. Last time on Morrowind, we recovered a bow for the gentleman within this building here. No, wait. It was back there. In fact, we have to do something for this woman here. So, let's continue on with our quest. We were sent here.
So, they've told me of you, Outlander, or shall I say, clan friend. You are hard-headed and ignorant, but perhaps it is not your fault. My Lord Ashkan says, you will ask me about the Navarian prophecies. He also says, I will test you against the Navarian prophecies, and I must do as his Lord Ashkan says. So, ask your questions, and I will test you.
All right, lady, I need to know about the Navarian prophecies.
There are many Navarian prophecies, and they suggest many things. Aspect and uncertain parents, the moon and star, sleepers, seven curses, the curse's bane, the prophecies of the stranger, the prophecies of the seven visions, the lost prophecies. Ask me of these things if you are patient, if you would be wise, or if you are patient to know. Just ask. Do I pass the test of the Navarian prophecies? Go ahead, Outlander. I am the wise woman. Ask your questions, and I will answer.
Okay. Let's start at the top and work our way down. Please tell me about the aspect and uncertain parents.
If what you say is true, you are indeed born on a certain day of uncertain parents. This is part of the prophecy, but many have the same birthday and many are not sure of their parents. It is interesting, but it does not make you Navarian.
Okay. Then, if you would, tell me about the moon and star.
Legend says Indoril, Navar's family standard, bore the moon and star, and Navar's armor and weapons bore this sign. Some say he bore a moon and star birthmark. Some say he has a magic ring marked with a moon and star. Others say he was born under a moon and star. In any case, I think the moon and star is a mark of the Navarian, and you do not have this mark, so you are not the Navarian.
Okay. Can you tell me about the sleepers? I've encountered a couple and they seem pretty messed in the head. Whoa, that is not what I meant to click on.
Rumors say in the towns, mad cultists called sleepers attack people, saying that Dagathur has awakened and will drive the Outlanders from Morrowind. Perhaps it is just a coincidence, but I think it is a sign of the Navarian, not necessarily a sign that you are the Navarian. Perhaps you are the Navarian. Perhaps the time of the Navarian has come, and you have come at the same time. This is not passing a test, but it may mean you have some part to play in the coming of the Navarian.
Seven curses.
It is another Ashlander prophecy of the Navarian. It is called the Seven Curses of Sharmat. But I do not know, and I know no one who does. It may be lost. Such things happen. A wise woman dies, or forgets, or clan is wiped out. Perhaps someone knows, but is keeping a secret. Perhaps it is in one of those many books of your settled peoples. I have heard that the descendant priests of the temples may have such books.
And I think there's only one last... Oh no. The Stranger. This is the best known of the Navarian prophecies. We call it the Stranger. When earth is sundered and sky is choked black, and sleepers serve the seven curses, to the heath there comes a stranger, journeyed far neath moon and star, though stark born, sire uncertain, his aspect marks his certain fate, wicked stalk him, righteous curse him, prophets speak, but all deny. Many trials make manifest the stranger's fate, the curse's bane, the touchstones try the stranger, many fall, but one remains. Intriguing. And now... Seven Visions. The full title of the prophecy is Seven Visions of Seven Trials of the Incarnate. Listen, and I will tell you the verses. Oh dear Lord. What he puts his hand to, that shall be done. What is left undone, that shall be done. The first trial. On a certain day to uncertain parents, incarnate moon and star reborn. Second trial. Neither blight nor age can harm him. The curse of flesh before him flies. Third trial. The cavern's dark Azura's eyes sees and makes to shine the moon and star. Fourth trial. A stranger's voice unties the houses. Three halls call him Horator. Horator. If I pronounced that wrong, I apologize. Fifth trial. A stranger's hand unites the Velothi. Four tribes call him the Navarian. Sixth trial. He honors blood of the tribes, of the tribe unmourned. He eats their sin and is reborn. And the seventh trial. His mercy frees the cursed false gods, binds the broken, redeems the mad. And one destiny. He speaks the law for Velothi's people. He speaks for their land and names them great. What does this prophecy mean? It tells us who Nidavarian will be, and the trials he must undergo before he fulfills his destiny. Some parts I understand, some parts I do not. I will answer your questions as best I can, but I cannot pretend to understand it all. Okay, I'm gonna turn the audio down a little bit. Hope that you guys actually caught what I said there.
Go ahead.
Apologize if you didn't. Do I pass the tests? You are not the Navarian. You are one who may become the Navarian. It is a puzzle, and a hard one. But you have found some of the pieces, and you may find more. Do you choose to be the Navarian? Then seek the lost prophecies among the descendant priests of the temple. Find the lost prophecies and bring them to me, and I will be your guide, and I will take these copies of the stranger and take these copies of the stranger and the seven visions. Now I have told you all I know. Go and think what I have told you, and do what must be done. The Lost Prophecies. There are Nenevarian prophecies that have been lost, the seven curses and others. Some are forgotten, some hidden, some deliberately lost. The wise women are the memory of the Velothi people. But it is a faulty memory, and we are mortal. And our knowledge dies with us. But we hear that the descendant priests of the temple study our Navarian prophecies and record them in books. Such written words never die.
You must go
to them and ask for these books and bring what you find to me. Okay. I can do that. Should be interesting. I'm gonna have a quick drink of water. Good old water. Okay.
Outlander.
Yes. Wow, this is running pretty good today. I think we're getting lucky. Temple priests. I'm gonna guess that we have to go to Vivek. Cool. Let's go to Cool. Let's do it the smart way, not that way. Not hitting the console either. What is the smart way, you might ask? The smart way is... is to do it in the dark. That's correct. Run as fast as you can with the boots of blinding speed. Yeah, well, try and catch me, you stupid bird. You ain't catching shit. I don't know how the fuck you're managing to keep up with me. What is this? You know what? We need to take off the boots and kill this damn bird. We also need to get some armor's hammers and get Larry to repair his shit. What the shit is... Okay. The boots. Let's put on the boots. No, can't go that way. Can't go that way. Well, whatever that thing is, it sounds... Jesus! Run away from it. Okay. Take off the boots. Let's find out what's attacking us. How do cliff racers keep up with me? I hope they change that in the new game. In Skyrim. Because there's no chance in hell a cliff racer would be able to keep up with me. Hey, shithead. How about you suck on my claymore? Yeah, fuck you. Okay. You know what? I'm gonna cut the video off here. Well, maybe not. You know what? I know you guys love staring at a black screen. Let's just see how much of this friggin' crap I can get done. I know, I'm sorry. You know what, yeah, fuck it. We'll cut the video off, we'll come back when I get closer to a town. Okay, I'm in Alderaan with a ton of wind and shit. And Larry's covering his eyes up from the horribleness. And we've got 14 gold. I think we need to sell something before we leave here. One second. Okay, actually, we're gonna cut the video off here. And I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm gonna have to figure out what it is that I'm supposed to do for these tests. And also get some money. So, Larry and I will see you very soon. Stay tuned.